The cord ties that we do, we'll make a loop, and then we'll run it through the loop, and basically then just tie a knot. So as you can see, I have a loop with a knot going around it. And so then we'll pull it tight, pinch it, and pull my knot right to that. It won't pull out from there, so we can let loose on the net. And we'll just do another knot or two around it in order to secure it. That should be enough. And then we're just going to snip the ends. And then we're going to melt the ends that we snipped. Let's make this one too. And we're going to melt the ends that we snipped in order to keep them from fraying out and making it ugly. As you can see, Price has the angle so that he's not melting the net or anything else besides the cord itself. That's good. Next, we're going to lace the net. The important thing is to start off with both sides being equal. So we'll pull it through. And we do this in a two-man team. So Price takes one side, I take the other, and we'll start by just light tension, and we'll feed it through to each other. So I feed mine to Price, he feeds his to me, and we just pull them both through. At this point, we're going to go back into the hole that we came from, or the eyelet that we came from. Pull it snug, and then we're going to go to the eyelet below. So as I pass to Price, he passes to me. Once we get there, then we can pull it tight. Next, we're going to go to the net post. And then, as you can see in our other hand, we have the side that we just passed, and we're holding it tight. And then at this point, we'll pull as tight as we can, and then we'll go back to where we came from. Now we've got it pulled tight to the next net post, and we can go down and do the next level. When in doubt which side to go to, we always go to the lower one of the two. When you get to this point, if you need to tighten it up above, you can do so by grabbing the thing on both sides and pulling it. Grab this side and pull it, grab this side and pull it, and then pull our bottom one, and we're back in snug. So this is a critical point where we have to tie it, and so we're going to keep the tension, but then one of the two people has to make a loop, So I'll make a loop with mine here. If we lose a little bit of the tension, we can always get it back, but it's important to get a good loop knot. And what I'll do is pass that through to Price, and he'll stick his end through it, and then pass it right back to me on this hole. And you may have to do that a couple of times to get the slack out. And I pull it one more time. So now we're ready to put a knot in it. And so all we're going to do is tie that same knot that we tied before. Gets us above the loop. Hold the pressure with one hand until we can pull it through. And then one more knot over it in order to keep it from sliding. At that point, all we do again is snip our ends and melt them, and we're good to go. It's important to cut the ends close to the knot, but not too close that it slips back through, and then just to melt them off so that so they don't fray and look ugly. All right, we're good to go.